Today, we have an exciting mini project lined up for you. A nifty trick for making your hover states stand out, coupled with a cool way to target all the siblings of an element you're hovering over. We will also delve into creating a fully responsive grid of perfect squares that can be used for showcasing logos, icons, or whatever your creative heart desires. But first, if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button so you never miss out on our latest web tutorials. Let's begin. First things first, let's lay the foundation with the HTML structure. Within a straightforward container with a class of cards, we have crafted individual cards, each containing an icon element using Font Awesome. If you are not familiar with Font Awesome, it's a toolkit used by millions of designers, developers, and content creators worldwide. Now let's break down the CSS, where the real magic happens. We start by defining our grid using Display Grid. The Grid Template Columns rule ensures a responsive layout, dynamically adjusting columns based on available space while maintaining a minimum width of 100 pixels. Adding a gap of 20 pixels introduces a delightful spacing between our cards. Next is individual card styling. Padding adds space inside each card. An aspect ratio 1 ensures a square aspect ratio, meaning its width and height will always be equal. This CSS property is relatively recent. Previously, we employed absolute positioning on a pseudo element to attain the same effect. Then we define font size, text, and background color, and add rounded corners for a polished look. The transition property introduces a smooth animation effect on hover, and the cursor pointer provides a visual cue. We ensure our icons remain perfectly centered within the card by converting it into a flex container. We then utilize the hover state of the parent container to slightly reduce the opacity of all individual cards. But here's where the real magic happens. Adding another hover handler over an individual card brings it back to life, changing the background color, achieving full opacity, and adding a slight scale effect for that extra pop. This is fantastic, but there's a slight frustration when hovering in the gap between children. They all fade out. Fortunately, we can solve this with pointer events. Pointer events none on the parent container instructs the browser to ignore mouse events on the element and all children. By then instructing the child element to listen to mouse events again with pointer events auto, we get a neat effect where hover events only run on the children, but still ignore the hover pseudo selector on the parent. What it effectively does is decrease the opacity of all cards upon hovering over the parent. Simultaneously, it restores the opacity of the one being hovered over. And that's it. Here's the final version of our responsive grid. It's eye-catching and ready to be customized to fit your website's aesthetic. Thank you for joining us today on Optimistic Web. If you found this tutorial exciting, don't forget to hit the like button, share it with your fellow developers, and subscribe for more thrilling web tutorials.